In this lesson, we will be looking into how Autodesk Inventor can utilize an AutoCAD DWG file or a DXF file inside of a 2D sketch environment. So, in the file that I have open is a brand new part file. And in the 2D sketch panel, I'm going to scroll on down, and I'm looking for the tool Insert AutoCAD File. The file that I'm going to insert is in your Chapter 2 exercise folder. So I'm just going to select on that. And go ahead and click on Open. And a wizard will appear that'll walk us through how to insert this geometry. In this first dialog box we're taking a look at, we have all of the AutoCAD layers. And in this case, we can turn them on or turn them off if we don't want to see that certain layer. On the upper right-hand side, you can change the background to white or black. And in this case, all I want is the geometry in the left side view here. So you notice what I can do in the graphics window is I can zoom and pan in that geometry section. But where it says selection on the left-hand side, I'm going to uncheck the all option. And I'm just going to do a crossing window, selecting the geometry in that left view as well as all of the dimensions. You'll also notice if I had geometry that I wanted to insert into this sketch, I could also select it from the layouts inside of AutoCAD, or the AutoCAD file. Go ahead and click on Next, and the next portion of this wizard is going to start asking us some more questions. You'll see a lot of this information is grayed out because this information is being placed inside of a sketch, because that's where we started the tool. So in this case, this was drawn in millimeters, so we have the correct unit, but I could change that to inch if it was drawn in inches. Constrain the endpoints, that's checked. And apply the geometric constraints. So that's where Inventor is going to go back and do some more analysis and apply the horizontal, vertical, perpendicular, parallel, tangent constraints for us. That's probably a good idea. In this case, we'll go ahead and click on Finish. And that geometry is inserted right into our sketch. So right now you'll notice that it says three dimensions are required. So first of all, I'm just going to drag the entire sketch over to our center point, which now takes me down to one dimension to fully constrain this. So to figure out what that is, start dragging some of the geometry around, and you'll see that it doesn't quite understand the horizontal and vertical for that bottom line. So let's apply a horizontal constraint to that bottom line. Now, with AutoCAD, these dimensions are now parametric. So if I double click on one of those, I can say, well, make that 150. Let's try that again, 150, not 15. Change that to 100. So the dimensions are exactly what you would expect. Fully parametric here. I could go back and do whatever we needed to. I could go back and delete out that inside geometry if I didn't want that to be there. So let's go ahead and close that file. And let's look at another option. So I can now open an AutoCAD file. So from my drop-down list here, we have all of our different file formats, and you'll understand that the AutoCAD DWG file is perfectly acceptable inside of Inventor. So I can open that up, or I can import it, and I can select that from the Options button down at the bottom here. Do I want to open it or import? Let's take a look at the import option first. So after selecting the DWG file to open, or I'm sorry, import, the wizard is going to walk us through, and it's fairly similar to the last wizard that we saw. In this case, it's asking us if this is an AutoCAD or AutoCAD mechanical file, in which case it is. If it was a mechanical desktop file, that option would not be grayed out, or if it was a DXF file, of course, that option would be available as well. For a configuration file, when we are done going through the wizard, we can create a configuration file, and then we could just select that file instead of walking through this wizard every single time. So we'll just go ahead and click on Next. And you see we get the exact same options here, and Inventor is remembering what I did with this file the last time. So I'm just going to select that same set of geometry. But as you can see here, this is where it gets a little bit different. Now I have more options that are available. Remember last time they were grayed out when I was inserting them into that sketch. So in this case, they're not 3D solid, so I don't even need to worry about that, but specify the units, millimeters, the endpoints. But on the right-hand side, where do I want that data to go? So I can reuse that in a drawing as part of the title block, a new border, a symbol. In this case, we are going to take it into a brand new part file in the sketch. If we have 3D wireframe, then we could tell Inventor to use that in a 3D sketch environment. On the bottom side here, these are going to be the template files that we're going to work with. I'm just going to go with the standard.ipt file. And we have mapping options on the bottom side here. So we have the layers inside of AutoCAD and what those layers are going to be called inside of Inventor. So we could change those if we needed to. And this is where we could save a configuration file. So I could only have to walk through this wizard once. Let's go ahead and click on Finish. And again, the geometry is inserted into a sketch. If I make that sketch active, you'll see again, three dimensions are required. I'm going to close out of this. And let's look at one more option. When we did the open, under the options, I want to make sure that open is the default here and not going to import it. Just go ahead and click on open. And what's interesting here, so right inside of Inventor, I opened up this AutoCAD DWG file. You'll notice it looks and feels like Inventor, but I have a few different tools that are available. I can go back and do the basic information study, if you will, that you would inside of AutoCAD. I want to do a measure, I want to print, zoom, everything that you would expect to do. But in this case, I can also grab the information on that left-hand side, copy it to the clipboard, start a new part file, and then I can paste that back in. Now with that paste, I'm going to right-click, I'm going to do options here, because I do want to verify the units that are going to be in place here, in this case millimeters, constrain the endpoints, and again apply the geometric constraints. So again, that was a right mouse click before I placed that. Just going to select on a point. The geometry comes back into play here. And again, we're down to three dimensions that are required. So those cover the three ways of using a DWG file inside of a sketch.